sweat and my rust. I'm breathing in the chemicals.
So, finally, I'm doing a barn tour, which, like, barn tour, for all of you, because people are like, make a barn tour, when's the next barn tour, and they're like, you're like, they're like, dying to see it, so, I brought it out, and I set it up, and I'm going to show you. So, let's do it over you. Ignore that crap, it's not there. It's just something. I can reach all the way over here. This is thingamajig and pasture. Alright, so we'll start off with the main entrance. Here we have our sign. This is welcome to Buckthorn Stables. Gotta get lower here so I can read this. Phone numbers, addresses, pretty much everything's fake. So yeah. So yeah, it has like the phone number and I try to do like little flyers too, so yeah. So this is the pasture is split in half from the mares and the stallion. So first we'll start off with the stallions. This is Zach. I'm not gonna be giving any show names, cause too many people in my last barn tour keep wanting to steal them, so yeah. This is Legacy, Jack. Here we have Hunter, Amulek, with some hay imaging, and that is Kodiak, a beautiful custom by Striker Stream Stables. They also have this water tub. It's at the bottom of a plastic cup. I have a tutorial on it somewhere on my channel. Okay, so here are the mares, and oh my gosh, my camera makes that one look like a ghost. That is so funny. Okay. So this is Rain on the... never mind. This is Grace. She's our younger Lipizzaner mare. This is the retired pony Star, and she's eating out of this Lego tire. Originally, I used the tire on the back of the Jeep, but I can't find it, so I'm using this tire. And they have a red water tub. And here is April in her full Sarah, and this hay holder thing I made. This is Patty. She's just looking over at the stallions. And here we have Jessica. And she's a custom I did. And this is the Safari LTD Morgan mare. Name is Maya. Here we have a tie-up post. This post idea wasn't mine, so I take no credit for it. This is Amos. He's a special edition from Germany. Somewhere else, I can't remember where he's from. And Jesse is grooming him, and then this is Lizzie. By the way, I have the most common names ever because I am so bad at remembering my people's names. Yet not horses, but people. I just can't remember people. And this is, they got little hooks. See hooks. So yeah. And this is an empty one with some saddle pads and a grooming kit. Then right here you have this random clump of lead ropes because I don't have a tech room and they're just sitting there because our farm people are very lazy. Right here is our donkey barn and paddock thing. This is Daisy. We also have this random staple meat bucket. And this stable mate tree, and then this container thing. And then in here we have Lewis. He's a retired Schleich donkey. And they have sliding doors to close, and then a chainsaw guard if they're supposed to stay in the barn, and I can't find it, so, oh, no, there it is. So, yeah. Okay, so this is our storage area. Here we have two buckets. This one, I can't remember where I got. And this is a bucket I made. The idea, again, is not mine. I'm not even gonna bother with it. Alright, so here we have a bunch of storage. We have some Christmas stuff, blankets, all this other junk and this random thing. I don't want to go into detail because in last barn tour I filmed it was way too long. And there's a sheep in here. What the heck is a sheep doing in here? Okay, that did not happen. Okay, so this is, we have some extra feed and some stall pasture toy things. This is the Melissa and Doug horse barn, but the stalls were way too small for me. They're like too small, I mean seriously people. So I made it a storage unit thing. And we have some jumps, which I need more poles. There's only two, and then this thing. And then a flower pot. And then over here we have, oops, we have a ladder, some jumps, Lego jumps. Okay. And then we have some more barrels and jumps, and this is literally, it's supposed to look like it has water, but it's just hot glue. Yeah, I'm pretty sure you guessed that, though. And close, okay. And then here we have a bunch of blankets because it's getting summer. This one was made by Schleich Staples. Thank you, I love it. And then we have a box, which I don't know what's inside it. I don't think it's, nope, nothing. And then just some pictures. And then we have this sleeping oversized chicken and then some oversized chicks. Like literally, look how big that is. And then Buddy and his squeaky toy. It's so cool, it's so squishy, squishy, squishy. I love squishy stuff. Whoa, it's creepy. Okay. And this is the farmer. He doesn't have a name, so his name is the farmer. And then just some dog food and a bed.
Face up, squishy and poopy.
Now we're heading into the main barn. Woo! So we have this briar hay bale, this grooming kit made by Conveyor Shell Studios, and this weird random purple bucket thing with hay looking stuff. So at the barn entrance, we have Gypsy, that is a mare. It's a custom by Striker Steam Stables, and this is Samantha. And then we have Julie. And then we have, I can't remember people's names. So I'm just, yeah, she just called the girl in the pink shirt. I'm sorry, I don't remember. This is also by Striker Steam Stables. I don't know if I mentioned that already. So starting off with the first stall, we have sliding doors. I was just like in so much desperation to put on sliding doors, I didn't even bother to stain these because that would take a long time. So yeah, they're sliding doors. Silver galleon 264. I am so sorry. Oh my gosh. I cannot remember your name. I am so sorry. I will put it right here. Just say the magic word. Bing! Mwahaha. Okay. I am so sorry. I didn't remember that. It is his nameplates. Oh, I totally forgot what I was going to say. She said it'd be a lot easier if I just put large jump rings and then bamboo stick poles on. Instead of this other thing, but you can get I also use the bamboo sticks for a lot of other things such as jumps. You can get them at Walmart in the kitchen section for like 97 cents. They're really cheap and they're like a lot of them, so yeah. Here is Roxy and she's a salt lick, and I'm gonna do this to all my salts, but I don't really necessarily want the glue the container to the wall, so I took wire and I looped it around. Oops, Ellie, come here. I looped it around this bottle cap and then I glued it to the thing so it like fits in and I can take it in and out. I haven't done that with all my stalls yet though, but yeah, it takes up a lot of wire. And there's another one. This is a stall toy. It's really realistic, good size. And they also have these bars which they can see into other stalls. I also have a chain stall guard for when the doors are open. So here is Jade, and she finally had her foal. Yay, little prince! It's so adorable. I'm so happy with him. I can't even remember where I got him. Where did I get you? Oh yeah, Christmas. It's so pretty. Okay. This is a homemade skull toy I made. The idea is not mine either. Well, part of it is. You take a mini bouncy ball, and I think you were originally supposed to put something else in it, but it, like, whatever it was too expensive, so I took a jump ring and wire, and I kind of wound it around the jump ring, and I stuck the wire into the ball, and I glued it, so it's a stall toy. Here we have Brianna. She is trying to get little Prince here to come get the carrot, but he's not really brave yet. He's still kind of young and not really know much about any trusting anybody but his mama, so yeah. And then we have this person sleeping. See, I always forget names. I don't even know her name. I got her from Horse Lover 667. I totally forgot the name of that person. And same here. This wheelbarrow person going nowhere, going somewhere. I don't remember her name either. This is April's stall, but I wanted to switch things up a little bit, and I put some other horses you haven't seen in my barn before in. So this is Nikita. She is the, actually, I don't remember the great breed, but she's retired. I also have stall mats. They're, it's black construction paper. That's what I use, the stall mats. And then these two next mares are Princess and Zara. They're not the nicest horses around the barn, and they're kind of selfish and mean. This is Zara, and here is Princess. Here is a mini tack room thingy-majig. I have said thingy-majig a lot in this video, and yet I don't usually say it anytime else, so I don't know what's up with that. So this random box has like squishy toy and a clipboard and a radio and this other grooming kit, and then here is some first aid kit, a halter, first aid kit thing, bed, blanket, random food container, and this random pool. This room really needs work. Here is Scarlett's stall. It used to say Amish, but I don't know, Amish just, I kind of took her out of my barn and replaced her with Scarlett, but Nick is in her stall right now. I thought I'd add her along like I did with Nikita. The horses, I don't usually switch out horses' stalls. Like, if one horse gets out of the stall, then another goes in. I don't usually do that because I just don't, but I wanted to do that in this video. Some things I don't, like, I've only done half of my sliding doors, and I haven't yet put all of my chainsaw guards on. Either that or most of them broke by my little sister. But I put these stable mate fences on, just kind of a stall guard thing until I can put sliding doors on and stall guards. Here we have this stack of hay. It came with this Melissa and Doug barn. This is the Safari LTD Appaloosa mare Nova, and she has this lead rope. Some of them have lead ropes because I haven't put any hooks yet. This is Maya's stall, the Safari LTD Morgan mare that was in the pasture. But Soraya is in here right now. Some people ask me where she came from. She came from the retired wagon set along with Patty, who was also in the pasture. Here is Rain Cloud. She is our oldest mare in the barn, and she's actually very old as even a model. I mean, like, most of her paint is missing, and I've had her since like 2008, so she's pretty old. And she has her little nameplate thing and a blanket. Of course you can see that. I don't need to point that out to you. This is Star Stall, but my custom in it is Abby, and I kind of resculpted her hair because she was missing her hair. And you have Abby, she's so sweetie. Here is Angel, and yep, she's Brianna's new horse because Brianna really wanted a horse, so she got one for her birthday. Yay! Was that saying one like birthday? Okay. Moving on. My arm hurts. Like, I'm like trying to reach, but it hurts so much. My arm is hurting. Okay, sorry. This is Della's little pilgrim, or Della. Oh my gosh, my arm hurts. And this is a pitchfork, which I kind of trimmed because it was like overly large stem thing. And bucket for manure, and then the shovel. And that's a leaf.
And I'm gonna come up.
Now have a relaxed arm. Much better. This is our rabbit hutch area thing. Imajig! Okay.
This is Bouncer. I like literally just came up with that name. He didn't have a name, and then like right before I pressed the play button, I'm like, his name's Bouncer. So yeah, Bouncer. I have like the most common names for bunnies. So yeah. I'm just like Bob, Phil, Bill, Pony, Hunter. Here is Spots, because he has spots. You can't get any more obvious than that, can you? Unless you call him Thingamajig. There we go. Name him Thingamajig. That's Thingamajig. No, I'm joking. That's Spot.
And this Schleich lock thing. It came in a set thing. Okay, I have to stop singing thing and Thingamajig. Here is the food and water, and this rubber bunny that I thought was so cute. He was at my local Schleich and Briar store in a different scoop that I went to, and it had a little rubber bunny for like 50 cents. So I'm like, it needs me. Here we have a cat named Salem. I named her after my cat and someone.
See, this is a Salem. This is Salem. Hey Salem, you hungry? Yes, you hungry, hungry. Food. We give you food. Can you say hi? Did you make someone cry? Did you make someone cry? You look so derpy. Okay, I'll give you. Yeah. Okay.
Okay, I need to get back to my barn tour. Yeah. Yeah, okay, feed you.
Okay, I'll feed you.
So yeah, I named this cat after my cat. That made any sense. Alright, so in here is Slippers. I know, right? Just such an awesome name for a bunny.
The Slippers.
It sounded so derpy there.
And then we have this random gate. It's breaking. There we go. Okay, it's fixed. Magic hand. Okay. I have this barrel of apples. It's Briar.
See, it's a bee. What else could it be? Broiling Barrel Company?
Here is a tie-up post, and people have been asking where did I get it. Actually, it came off of a kitchen playset. Like, it was like hooked on to like an oven stove like this, but like we got rid of it, so I'm like, give me the handle.
What happened? They gave me the handle, and now that I turn the handle into a post.
And this is a hose. It came with Briar too. It's a hose. It's such an awesome hose. It is blue! I love blue. Here is our oversized dog named Fang, or Husky. I customized him. Yay, he's awesome. Sort of. I mean, like, he doesn't have any color to him, but whatever. He's one of my first customs, so I don't really care. I'm running out of breath. And I stand. Stand. Can you just freaking stand? Thank you. This random person. Oh my gosh. I can't remember her name. Here we have our feed room. Yay, feed rooms! This used to be Princess's Old Stall, but then like I'm like, screw it, and I turned it into a feed room. So carrots, there's a tutorial on them, because I don't want to go into detail.
Treats.
Magic.
Now you know my secret.
Oh, it fell! Yeah, it's crumble. I don't know how that happened. Spray it all up! My friend made me awesome spray bottle. She's so neat. Gonna focus for the YouTube. And then this is like, you know, like those paint containers, like thick. Oh my gosh, it fell. I'm like bad at dropping stuff today. Look at these little containers, I'm sure you know what I'm talking about. My paint thingies. Oh my gosh, it's a thingy. Okay, I'm just gonna leave that. I'm like, yeah, I'm getting frustrated. Okay. See, I had more right here, and then some of here, electrolytes, and then some salt, and that's sugar.
Yep, sugar.
Sugar.
This is another stablemate bucket. Oh yeah, you can see my camera thingy, okay.
It's a thingy!
There's a bucket. And then this is feed. This container came from some restaurant french fry thing. And then I got all these major feed containers. That's Joe. He's the owner. I like Joe.
Joe.
Hello, Joey.
Are some oats. Oats.
I like to eat. Open some bananas.
I have no idea where that came from. There's some more of this stuff. And then we have these containers. If you want to know where I got them, ask, because I don't want to spend too much time telling you who. This is our cow pasture thing, and the cows have nothing. They're just like eating dirt. I'm joking, just pretend like there's nice green grass and a bunch of hay, a nice little shelter. Just use your imagination. It doesn't have a name, I totally forgot his name, but like, only that one has a name, really. They have like one thing, it's just, yeah. And then, like I said, ignore that. I'm gonna recustomize this later on, but I'm just like leaving all my crap in there. We have this wall or the fence. And then finally, Brittany and Carrie came. This is Zero's owner, and that's Pencil's owner. Yep, they're just as bad as their horses. And this is a trailer, and it has hay. I don't have a Jeep anymore, so I'm just kind of a Jeepless trailer. And then here is Cody, and riding him is Sarah. And then here we have, I totally forgot her name. I think it's Shauna. I'm pretty sure it's Shauna. Either that or that pink person. Oh, it just bit my hand. It hurt. Okay, I'm pretty sure her name's Shauna. And this is Scarlett. Oh, yeah. That concludes my Schleich barn tour. And oh my gosh, my camera's going dead. I hope you enjoyed this, because it took a lot of work to set it up. And I probably won't be doing one for a while, because nothing else will really probably update. Probably, unless I get like a stallion barn, which I probably won't. Okay, I'm sorry. I thought I heard my cat meowing like she's like dying or something. Yeah, guys, hope you're happy, because this is like, you're all dying. It sounded like you're all dying to see it, so. Yeah, I better end this. I hope it's not like 20 minutes long. So yeah, thank you for watching. Bye, fellow people. Subscribers, people. Yeah, guys, bye.